Congratulations, Brianna, on the publication of Everything That Rises.
Thank you.
You're a researcher, so why did you want to write the book and take on all the extra work that that entails alongside your day job?
I really wanted to write something different, something that I'd not written before, something I'd not read before, something that really got to the emotional heart of why we get to do the work that we do and why the climate crisis grips me so much. And I guess the like spark for that for me was President Trump's election. I'm an American, born and raised, and we spent 4 years helping the Least Developed Countries Group negotiate the Paris Agreement, which was adopted in 2015. And months later, in 2016, our newly elected President Trump withdrew the US from the Paris Agreement. And for me, that was just so completely devastating. And I just couldn't stand going to work every day and having to look our colleagues in the Least Developed Countries Group in the eye, knowing that the US had just done what it did. And suddenly I was just so inspired to write a story that was different from the research work that we get to do here. Something that really got to the emotional heart of the work that we do in the UN and why the climate grips me the way that it does. And that is why I started this journey to kind of delve into a more personal story of our work and our time together. So yeah.
Is there anything you want to add about the different way of telling a story that this afforded you compared to research outputs that you normally work on at IIED?
I loved that this taking a personal lens on the work that we did also meant I got to take an emotional lens on it. I got to talk about the people I love in a really holistic way and kind of just really delve into the heart of why the climate crisis grips me and grips so many of us and the different ways that happens in a way that was gonna, you know, keep people turning pages and be less of a research-oriented focus, which is what we tend to do here. I liked that I get to come at it from a different side and really hook people in, so yeah.
Mm-hmm. You were featured in The Guardian recently, congratulations, and you were quoted as saying that climate negotiations are inherently abusive, but I know that you speak from a place of deep commitment to that process and also personal experience of abuse growing up with a violent father. So can you talk a bit more about what you meant when you drew that comparison?
Yeah. This story is basically me comparing climate violence to domestic violence. And I have an experience of domestic violence. My father was violent and I grew up really terrified. In fact, the memoir opens with a recurring dream I had as a child that my father was going to kill me. And the more I came to experience the climate crisis, the more it felt so familiar. So much of what living with the climate crisis looks like reminds me of the house I grew up in, just the stress and the fear and the anxiety that kept me up at night, just this knowledge that violence is inevitable and it's going to be inflicted on those least responsible and it's really only a matter of time. And then the work that we get to do, we work for the Least Developed Countries Group, the 46 poorest countries on Earth. They've emitted less than 1% of cumulative greenhouse gas emissions, and yet they are 5 times more likely to die in climate-enhanced disasters than my people are in the US and where we live are in the UK. And watching them come to the UN climate negotiations and try to demand the people with power and the people who are responsible stop the violence, again, sent me right back into this place of familiarity with the abusive house that I grew up in. And it's just, once I started making the comparison, the more and more I could see those parallels. And I really wanted in the book to give readers a different way of entering that kind of space, to see the climate injustice for what it is and how it manifests in a lot of different spaces in a lot of different ways. Wove those two stories together in order to make that parallel. So yeah.
And so what would you like people to take away from Everything That Rises?
I really want the people who have power, which I include myself as an American in, include all of us in the UK in to use our power and our voice to shape our collective response to climate change. I want everyone to vote for officials who are going to bring greenhouse gases to zero, to protest our current inaction by our governments, and to divest their money and their time out of fossil fuels. I think these are the strongest things we have to change the course that we're on and protect ourselves and our friends around the world. More than that, though, I want people, I wrote this story the way that it's written to get across an emotional connection, and what that also inspired in me when talking about climate violence and domestic violence, which are difficult things to talk about, also pointed me towards what got me through those situations. And really that was love. All the people I love and who made such a difference to me and continue to inspire me to write and research and do the work that we get to do. And so really, like, I think of this as a love story, and I really want readers to see that for themselves as well. And yeah, just think about all the people who made such a difference to you and who you would do anything to protect, and work to have a safe future for. And for me, this story was about my childhood best friend and my mom and my university best friends and the amazing people I met moving to the UK, my new home, and continue to work with. This is a love story, and really the highest form of love, I think, is climate action. And I want readers to take that away.